that you want?
What I have always wanted. To instruct you. To instruct you. To instruct you. To instruct you. To instruct you.
Sword fight. You must think first, right? Before you move.
I, William Jefferson Clinton, do solemnly swear.
I, George Walker Bush, do solemnly swear.
I, Barack Hussein Obama, do solemnly swear.
That I will faithfully execute the office of President of the United States.
That I will faithfully execute the office of President of the United States.
That I will faithfully execute the office of President of the United States.
That I will execute the office of President of the United States faithfully.
And will to the best of my ability.
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 Preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the United States.
Preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the United States.
Preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the United States.
Preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the United States.
So help me God.
So help me God.
So help me God.
So help me God.
We need to understand that the presidency is nothing but a puppet seat. The president is controlled by people a lot more powerful than the president.
I wanted absolute power.
But you're the president. You have power.
No, I'm just a figurehead.
What?
I don't have any control.
Your office? The White House?
Merely puppets. Pawns in a game. Hard to believe, isn't it? But it's the truth. Even if a pawn becomes a queen, it is still just a playing piece. Politics, the military, the economy, they control it all. They even choose who becomes president. The space defense, income tax reduction, and national missile defense programs. Every policy that's been credited to me was actually done according to their instructions.
What is the proper relationship, what should be the proper relationship between a chairman of the Fed and a president of the United States?
Well, first of all, the Federal Reserve is an independent agency, and that means basically that there is no other agency of government which can overrule actions that we take. So long as that is in place and there is no evidence that the administration or the Congress or anybody else is requesting that we do things other than what we think is the appropriate thing, then what the relationships are don't frankly matter.
Those moments in history in which there is the necessity for a new world order, A, because of what's taken place in the Middle East, the rise of different kinds of groups, and B, what's happened in Asia, meaning that there has been a shift from the West to the East.
There's a need for a new world order.
Within the next 4 years, we will see the emergence of a new international order.
The beginning of a new international order.
Henry Kissinger, former Secretary of State, we began, as I said, this series of conversations with former Secretaries of State, with people from not just the United States, but other countries, talking about this new world order and where we go from here.
The European Union as a creation to the organization of empires.
We have before us the opportunity to forge for ourselves and for future generations a new world order, a world where the rule of law, not the law of the jungle, governs the conduct of nations. When we are successful, and we will be, we have a real chance at this new world order, an order in which a credible United Nations can use its peacekeeping role to fulfill the promise and vision of the UN's founder.
Now we can see a new world coming into view, a world in which there is the very real prospect of a new world order. In the words of Winston Churchill, a world order in which the principles of justice and fair play protect the weak against the strong. A world where the United Nations, freed from Cold War stalemate, is poised to fulfill the historic vision of its founder.
After 1989, President Bush kept said, and it's a phrase that I often use myself, that we needed a new world order, and instead it looks like we got a lot of disorder. And we still, and after 9/11, we've been more sensitive to this.
We have confidence because freedom is the permanent hope of mankind, the hunger in dark places, the longing of the soul. When our founders declared a new order of the ages.
There have been differences between America and Europe. No doubt there will be differences in the future. But the burdens of global citizenship continue to bind us together. A change of leadership in Washington will not lift this burden. In this new century, Americans and Europeans alike will be required to do more, not less. Partnership and cooperation among nations is not a choice.
If this were a dictatorship, it'd be a heck of a lot easier. Just so long as I'm the dictator.
More secretive, you know, the New World Order was talked about 30 or 40 years ago, and nobody would say it out and open. Now they talk about the New World Order, or they just think the world would be better off if we had one world government. I don't.